So students, let us study one important concept of ray optics here. It is rotation of plane mirror, and we'll solve two examples based on the same. So I will explain you the concept of rotation of the plane mirror. What it says, let us consider a plane mirror which is placed horizontally like this. This is a plane mirror kept horizontally like this. This is the plane mirror. For this we will take a normal which is perpendicular to this plane mirror. This normal is perpendicular to the plane mirror. Okay, this is normal. This is the position of the mirror. Okay, first I will draw the incident ray here. So this is the incident ray which is coming from this side, let us suppose. This is incident ray. Okay, and this is the angle of incidence, the angle between normal and incident ray. This is angle of incident, and this ray will reflect in such a way that the angle of incidence will be equal to angle of reflection. So this is reflected ray. Let us denote this reflected ray by R. So what is I? This is point of incidence O. I is angle of incidence. This capital I stands for incident ray, and this red line stands for normal, and this black ray which is reflected back in such a way that angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. This is a situation. Law of reflection says that this angle, the angle of incidence must be equal to angle of reflection. Then if I suppose keeping incident ray same, keeping incident ray without disturbing incident ray, let us suppose that this mirror is rotated either in clockwise direction or in anti-clockwise direction through a small angle like this. If this mirror is rotated through a small angle in this direction, anti-clockwise direction, then this will be the position of the mirror. This is new mirror at this position, which is rotated through an angle theta. This is the position of new mirror. So the mirror is rotated through an angle theta. This is M dash is the new position of the mirror, which is rotated through an angle theta. If mirror is rotated through an angle theta, then normal also rotates through an angle theta, because this is normal and this is mirror. If mirror is rotated like this and the normal of the mirror will also rotate like this, then let us suppose the normal comes here. So what is this? This is the new position of the normal. Since mirror is rotated through an angle theta, its normal will also rotate through an angle theta. What is N dash? N dash stands for new position of the normal. Then angle between this is theta, because mirror is rotated through an angle theta in this direction. Therefore, normal also rotates through an angle theta like this. Okay, because mirror and normal are perpendicular to each other. Now this is the incident ray. This is the incident ray. I did not disturb incident ray, but I rotated mirror through an angle theta. Normal also rotates. Now this is incident ray. This is the new normal. Then what is the angle between incident ray and normal now? angle between incident ray and normal is this. This is incident ray, this is normal. The angle between incident ray and normal is this, which is equal to I plus theta. Since mirror is rotated through an angle theta, normal rotates like this. This is the incident ray and this is new normal. And the angle between incident ray and the new normal, shifted normal, is I plus theta. So, if this is I plus theta, then for this incident ray, reflected ray will also rotate like this. For the new incident ray, for the new position of the mirror, this will be the reflected ray. This is I plus theta. Therefore, angle of reflection should also be I plus theta. Angle of reflection should also be equal to I plus theta like this. Since this is the new position of the reflected ray, if this angle is I plus theta and this angle must be equal to I plus theta, because law of reflection says that angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. Then, by how much angle the reflected ray is rotated? This is the angle we want. R, O, R dash. See, from here to here it is I. From here to here it is I. See, from here to here it is totally will be 2I. This is 2I. This is I plus theta and this is I plus theta. Then total angle I O R dash. I O R. I O R. This is I. This is I. I O R will be 2I. This is I plus I. 2I. Then this is I O R dash, I O R dash. This is I plus theta and this is I plus theta. I O R dash. This angle will be 2I plus 2 theta, which is nothing but 2 times of I plus theta. Followed this. This is 2I. This is 2I plus theta. In this entire 2 times of I plus theta, if I subtract this 2i, this is 2i, this is 2r times of I plus theta. In this 2i plus theta, if I subtract this much angle, then I will get this angle R O R dash. That means the angle through which reflected ray rotated, this angle R O R dash will be equal to R O R dash will be equal to this entire angle 2i plus theta minus 2i minus 2i. This is I, this is I, this is I O R dash. In this I O R dash, if I subtract I O R, I O R dash minus I O R will give me R O R dash, which is R O R dash is equal to 2 times of I plus theta minus 2I, then we put 2I plus 2 theta minus 2I, then R O R dash should be equal to, these two will get cancelled, this is 2 theta. What is the conclusion based on this is, if mirror is rotated through an angle theta, then the reflected ray will rotate by an angle 2 theta. Without disturbing incident ray, without disturbing this incident ray, if mirror is rotated through an angle theta in anticlockwise direction, then the reflected ray will also rotate in the same direction by an angle 2 times of this theta. That is, the conclusion that we can make on the basis of this is, if or by keeping by keeping incident ray fixed. If mirror is rotated through angle theta, then reflected ray rotates by an angle 2 theta in same sense of rotation, or you can say in the same direction. If mirror is rotated in anti-clockwise direction, then the reflected ray rotates in anti-clockwise direction. This is the conclusion. Once again, you just observe the figure. Mirror is rotated. This is incident ray. This is reflected ray. Angle between these two will be 2i. Then if mirror is shifted by an angle theta, normal will shift through an angle theta. Then keeping incident ray fixed means now the angle of incidence will become I plus theta. For this, angle of reflection becomes I plus theta. Then this entire angle becomes 2 times of I plus theta. In this 2 times of I plus theta, if you subtract this 2i, then we will get this angle. This is nothing but the angle through which reflected ray is rotated. If mirror is rotated by an angle theta, reflected ray rotates by an angle 2 theta if we keep incident ray fixed. So on the same concept, we'll solve these two questions. One is from NCERT textbook, other is from previous NEET exam. Okay, see. Now I will solve this question. See this. What is happening here? Light is incident normally on a plane mirror which is attached to a galvanometer. The purpose of attaching galvanometer, suppose galvanometer mirror is attached to galvanometer, if you supply some current in the galvanometer, then the galvanometer will show some deflection, inside deflection, and to that head of the galvanometer mirror is attached. Since coil inside the galvanometer rotates, mirror will also rotate. The purpose of attaching this mirror, or if mirror is attached to galvanometer, some current is supplied in the galvanometer, the coil inside the galvanometer will deflect. Since this mirror is fixed to the galvanometer, if coil inside the galvanometer rotates, then the mirror also rotates. That we'll study in the galvanometer, but here we are purpose of attaching that mirror to the galvanometer. Or if galvanometer coil deflects, then mirror also deflects. See, this is the question. Here a mirror is there. This is, suppose it is a screen or a wall which is fixed at fixed some distance, which is given in the question that it is 1.5 meter. Then what is this? Light is incident normally on the plane mirror which is attached to the galvanometer, retraces backwards as shown in the figure. From this screen, if light is incident normally on this plane mirror, this will be the incident ray. If it incident normally on the plane of the mirror, we know that it will come back in the same direction. So what is my this arrow indicates it is incident ray, and this arrow indicates it is reflected ray. Okay, if I say that this mirror is, now this is incident ray, this is if some current is supplied in the galvanometer, the mirror is found to be rotated through an angle theta in this direction. If this position of the mirror, if mirror is rotated like this in this direction, they are saying that a current in the coil produces a deflection of 3.5 degree of the mirror. See, a current supplied in the coil, the mirror is rotated through an angle of 3.5 degree. If mirror is rotated in this direction through clockwise direction, through an angle 3.5 degree or through an angle theta, we know that this reflected ray, we are not disturbing incident ray. Incident ray is fixed. This is the mirror. We are just rotating the mirror. In which direction? See, this is clockwise direction. In the same direction, the reflected ray will rotate like this. Incident ray is fixed. But the reflected ray will rotate like this. This is the earlier reflected ray. Then reflected ray will rotate like this. How? By what angle reflected ray will rotate? Just now we studied it. This will be 2 theta. If this is 3.5 degree, then the rotation of the reflected ray will be, this is 2 theta. What is, this is O, I suppose. This is R, this is R dash. Then what is R, O, R dash is equal to? This will be 2 theta. If a mirror rotates by an angle theta, it rotates by an 2 theta. What is the angle of rotation of the mirror? It is 3.5 degree. Then angle of rotation of reflected ray is 7 degree. Then what they are asking you is, suppose initially if the light is incident like this, then after reflection from the mirror, here it will form a spot, reflected spot we say. They are asking you what is the displacement of the reflected spot of the light on the screen. If reflected ray goes like this by 2 theta, then the spot will be shifted here. The spot, reflected spot will be shifted here. Let us say the displacement of this spot is x, and this distance is 1.5, and this angle is 7 degree. Then we say that tan 7 degree is equal to opposite by adjacent, then will be x by 1.5 degree. Then x is equal to 1.5 degree into tan 7. Tan 7 it is given as 0.12 here. 0.12. Then x will be equal to, this is 15 2s are 30. Carry 3, 15 1s are, this will be 18. Then I will keep the point here after 3 digits like this. Then x will be equal to 0.1 meter. This is the displacement of that reflected spot. How we calculated it? Because the concept is rotation of the plane mirror. If plane mirror is rotated through an angle 3.5 degree, and the reflected ray will rotate by an angle 7 degree, then the spot will be displaced here. Then we can find the displacement of that spot very easily. Okay, this question is based on the concept of rotation. Here is one more question which is asked in NEET 2017. This question also, let us try to find the solution. This is the question. Okay, see this. How are you? A beam of light. Okay, a beam of light from a source L is incident on a plane mirror fixed at a distance x. See, this is, let us say, this is source and this is plane mirror. A beam of light is incident on a plane mirror fixed at certain distance x from the source. See, this is the source of light L, and the plane mirror is fixed at a distance x from the source. If a beam of light is incident on the mirror, the beam is reflected as a spot on a scale. Here we placed a scale here just above the source. This is scale having some reading like this. If the light, the beam of light is incident on the plane mirror, then what is happening? At a distance x, the beam is reflected back as a spot on the scale. This is incident ray and it is reflected back to form a spot here. This is a reflected spot that we are observing on the screen placed at a distance x. Then on the scale just placed above the source, when the mirror is rotated through an angle theta, you observe the question. When mirror is rotated through an angle theta, small angle theta, then the spot of the light is found to move through a distance y on the screen, on the scale. If this mirror is rotated through an angle theta, from this position, if mirror is rotated like this through an angle theta, it is observed that this spot will be displaced by an angle, by a distance y on the scale. From this, the spot is moving here. What it means? It means that reflected ray shifted through an angle theta. If reflected ray moves like this, then the spot will come here. This is r dash. If this mirror is rotated through an angle theta, then rotation of the reflected ray is 2 theta. That is a concept we have studied. Then it is found that the spot will move through a distance y on the scale. The angle theta is given by, they asked you what is this angle theta. It's very simple. When the mirror is rotated through an angle theta, reflected ray will rotate through an angle 2 theta. It is displaced. In the previous question, this displacement was asked. Now, this angle they are asking. It's very simple. In terms of x and y, I should get the answer. See, options are given like this. In terms of x and y, I should get the answer. We know that this angle is theta, means this is 2 theta. This is tan 2 theta is equal to, this is y, this is x. This is y by x, which implies that for small angle, tan 2 theta will be just 2 theta. 2 theta is equal to y by x. Then theta will be equal to y by opposite by adjacent. Okay, y by 2x. Follow this. Tan 2 theta is equal to opposite by adjacent. Then for small angle, it is 2 theta by is equal to y by x. Theta is equal to y by 2x. This is our answer. Follow this. These two questions are based on the same concept. Okay. Thank you.